Hello everyone. Today we are going to see another topic in material technology. So next topic is non-metallic materials. Everybody knows what is non-metallic. Mainly it comes under the polymers, ceramics, fibers, and composites. So here we are going to see types of polymers, what is polymer, what is engineering polymer, and properties and applications, and different variety of polymers. So what is polymer? So everybody knows it's non-metallic and it's not conductive, corrosion resistant, lightweight, but we cannot use for thermal application. And recycling the polymer is very tough job. And appearance of real linear polymer chains are recorded using the atomic force microscopy on surface under the liquid medium. So here from generally they will use atomic force microscopy, they will call as AFM. Generally they will use for atom arrangement in the metal and non-metal also, but non-metal we cannot use directly, we have to use under liquid medium. And chain contour length of the polymer is maximum 204 nanometer, and thickness of the polymer is approximately 0.4 nanometer. A polymer is a large molecule composed of repetitive structure units. So polymer generally is like CH bond only repetitive. How close is it arranged? It depends on the arrangement type of polymer it will be there. And those subjects are typically connected by covalent chemical bonds. Although the terms of polymer is sometimes taken to refer to plastics, it actually encompasses a large class of natural and synthetic material with a wide variety of properties. Because of the extraordinary range of the property of polymer material, they can play on the essential and a unique role in everybody's life. However, the thinning, pollution, everything, but we cannot avoid the polymer. And this role ranges from the similar synthetic plastic, elastomer, to natural biopolymers such as nucleic acids, proteins that are essential for life. And natural polymers like shellac, ampere, and natural rubber have been used for centuries, more years we are using. And the variety of other natural fibers, plastics also exist, such as cellulose, which is the main constituent of wood and paper. And list of synthetic polymers, including like synthetic rubber, pectolite, neoprene, nylon, PVC, polyester, polyethylene, polystyrene, polypropylene, silicon, and many more. So we cannot stop here. There are a number of variety of polymers are available. And most commonly, the continuous linked backbone polymers they are using for preparing plastic consist mainly of carbon atoms. And simple example of polyethylene, whose repeating unit is based on the ethylene monomer. However, other structures do exist, like for example, elements such as silicon for familiar materials such as silicones, example being silibutadiene and waterproof plumbing sealant, and oxygen is also commonly present in the polymer backbones, such as those like polyethylene, glycol, polysaccharide, and DNA. Polymers are studied in the field of polymer chemistry, polymer physics, polymer science, and also polymer materials. And etymology. What is etymology? The word polymer is derived from the Greek word poly means many and mero means pot, many pots. The terms contain coin in 1833 by John Jacob Berzelius, although his definition of the polymer was quite different from the modern definition. So historical development is starting in 1811, Henry coin and work divide the cellulose and component and perhaps in the nature work, and he developed the organization later in the 19th century, improved the durability of the natural polymer and wrapper, significantly the first popularized semi-synthetic polymer. In 1907, Liu Baekeland created the first completely synthetic polymer and backlight by reacting phenol and formaldehyde at precisely controlled temperature and pressure, and backlight was then publicly introduced in 1909. So don't think worry, it's a polymer subject. It will be like that only, it will be totally different from the your automobile engineering subject. And so we can see the polymer synthesis. Can you able to see the structure? Carbon carbon with one hydrogen, two hydrogen, and three hydrogen. If this bond will be continued, N is meaning for structural continuous. It's like continuous bonding. The repeated unit of the polymer is the polypropylene. The same structure to repeat a number. The polymerization is the process, the combination of many small molecules known as monomers into the covalent bonded chain. During the polymerization process, some chemical groups may be lost from the each monomer. This is the case, for example, the polymerization of PET polyesters. The monomer are terephthalic acid and ethylene glycol, but the repeating unit is, can you able to see here, hexane carbon and 6 carbon, 4 hydrogen carbon, 2 oxygen carbon, 2 hydrogen carbon, 2 hydrogen and oxygen. This is which correspond to the combination of two monomers which loss of two water molecule. The distinct space of each monomer that is incorporated into a polymer is known as a repeated union unit or monomer residue. And laboratory synthesis. The polymer synthesis is totally different than the laboratory synthesis. Laboratory synthesis methods generally divide into the two categories. One is step growth polymerization and chain growth polymerization. And the essential difference between the two is that in chain growth polymerization, monomers are added to the chain one at a time only. Whereas the instant growth polymerization chain monomer mainly combine with one another directly. However, some newer methods such as the plasma polymerization do not fit neatly into the any category. And synthetic polymerization reacts may be carried out without catalyst. And laboratory synthesis of biopolymers, essentially of proteins, is the area of intensive research. And what is biological synthesis? This term, first time you might have heard biological synthesis, especially the polymer. There are three main classes of biopolymers: the polysaccharides, polypeptides, and polynucleotides. In living cells, they may be synthesized by enzyme-mediated process, such as the formation of DNA catalyzed by DNA polymerase. And the synthesis of protein involves the multiple enzyme-mediated process to transcript the genetic information from DNA to RNA and subsequently translate that information to synthesis the specific protein from the amino acids. The protein may be modified further following transition in order to provide appropriate structure and function. It can able to see the polymeric biological synthesis. It is very difficult to understand. It's a detailed thing we can able to discuss while coming to the class. And modification of the natural polymers. How they doing modification and doing the definite process, we can be able to see. Mainly commercially important polymers are synthesis by chemical modification of natural occurring polymers. Prominent example include the reaction of nitric acid cellulose to form nitrocellulose and the formation of vulcanizing rubber by heating natural rubber in the presence of sulfur. And polymer properties. The polymer properties broadly divide into the several classes based on the scale which the property is defined as well as upon its physical basis. The most basic property of the polymer is identified as its consistent monomers. A second set of properties known as the microstructure, the essential descriptive arrangement of the monomer between the polymer and the scale of single chain. Those basic structure property play a major role in determining the bulk physical property of the polymer, which describe how the polymer behave as a continuous macroscopic material. If you take the chemical property at the narrow level scale, that describe how the chain interact through the various physical forces. At a macroscopic scale, if you take that describes how the bulk polymers interact with the other chemicals and solvents. That is more important. If you see the grain growth, overall annealing and secondary regeneration growth, new grains at the expansion of the neighbors occurring the temperature above regeneration temperature. This process results in a coarse grain structure and undesirable. So monomer and the repeat units, the identification of the monomer residues comprising a polymer is its first and most important attribute, and polymer nomenclature is generally based upon the type of monomers residues comprising of polymers. A polymer that can contain only a single type of repeated unit are known as homopolymers, while polymer containing mixture of repeat units are known as copolymers. The polystyrene, for example, is composed of only the strength monomer residue and is therefore classified as a homopolymer. Ethylene vinyl acetate, EVA, generally they will come, and the other end contain more than one variety of the repeated unit and is thus the copolymer. Some biological polymers also composes a variety of different but structurally related to monomer residue. For example, polynucleotides such as DNA are composed of variety of nucleic acids. The polymer molecule containing ionized subunit is known as the polyelectrode or ionomer. And microstructure. If you see the microstructure of polymers, sometimes we call conification, but generally microstructure is the correct word related to the physical arrangement of monomer series along with the backbone of them. Backbone of them is the backbone of the chain. Those are the element of polymer structure that trigger the breaking of covalent bond in order to change. Structure has a strong influence on the other property of polymer. For example, two samples of natural rubber maybe exhibit different durability, even though their molecule comprise the same monomer. If you see the polymer architecture, see, don't think it's like rangoli. So if the small dot is mean it's like carbon, and if the big dot is like hydrogen or oxygen bonds. So branch point in a polymer, a important microstructure feature determine the polymer property is the polymer architecture. The simplest polymer architecture is a linear chain. So you can able to see the linear chain. Like in this way. A single backbone with new branches. Okay, a related unbranching architecture is a ring polymer. A branched polymer molecule is composed of main chain with one or more substituent side chain or branches. The special type of branch polymer includes tar polymers, comb polymers, brush polymer, tenderized polymer, layered and tenderness. These are the type of branches in the polymer. Branching of the polymer chain affects the ability of the chain to slide past one another by altering intermolecular force. In turn, affecting the bulk physical polymer property. If you take long chain branches, we may increase the polymer strength, toughness, and the glass transition temperature due to the increase in the number of enlargement per chain. The effect of such long chain branches on the size of the polymer in solution is characterized by the branching attack. So random length and attractive short chain, on the other hand, may reduce the polymer strength due to the disturbance of organization and also may be likewise reduce the crystallinity of the polymers. If you see the good example of the effect is related to the range of physical attribute of polyethylene, high density polyethylene, HDPE, has a very low degree of branching, is quite stiff and is used to applications such as like melt jar, low density polymer. Polyethylene, next type, LDPE. PE, on the other hand, has significant number of both long and short branches, it's quite flexible and also is used in applications such as plastic films. Can you able to see the olden days movie films? And dendrimers are special case of polymer where every monomer unit is branched. So when you want to study this polymer everything as an engineer, you must know what are the types of the polymers available. You may not feeling like wire, sorry, boring the subject, but subject may be boring, but as an engineer you should know, and you should know some basics about the polymers. And this trend, like tenders, this trend to reduce the intermolecular chain and entanglement and crystallization. Alternatively, dendritic polymers are not perfectly branched but share similar property to dendrimers due to their high degree of branching. The architecture of the polymer is often physically determined by the functionality of the monomer form which it is formed. This property of the monomer is defined as the number of reaction sites at which made from the chemical covalent bonds. The basic functionality required for the forming even a large changes to bonding site. Higher functionality genes branch are even class linked or the network polymer chains. And I don't want to give much theory for you guys. So gradually trying to increase the PG and also increase the strength and toughness. And you can assume like where you can use the car tires they use for this grass length. And eraser rubber on the other hand for the snort grass length and flaking the rubber and prevent the damage of paper. If you are using grass length means like tire, it never erase. It will tear our paper. So the cross-link suggestion branch point is that the four are more distinct chain element. One is like a polymeric molecule with high degree of the cross-link referred to the polymer network. Significantly high cross-link concentration may lead to the formation of an infinite network also known as gel, in which network of the chain is the ultimate unlimited extent, essential all chain have been linked into the one molecule. What is chain length? The physical property of the polymer are strongly depends on the size and or length of the polymer chain. For example, as the chain length is increased, melting and boiling temperature increase quite quickly. In fact, resistance also tend to increase with the chain length. As does the viscosity or resistance of flow of the polymer in its melt state. If we think chain is short, obviously thermal conductivity, melting point, boiling point, and the everything will reduce, especially impact resistant. Although if the bond chain is very small, definitely it will. And the common mean of expression is the length of chain, the degree of polymers and which contribute the number of monomers incorporated with the chain. And monomer arrangement in the copolymers. You can able to see here how the arrangement. First one, A. 3A continuously, B, A, B. See here, A, B, 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 3B continuously, A, B. A, B, B, A. If you see here, all approximately this is 3, 6, 9, 10A continuously. See here, 5B continuously, 5A continuously. This is also quite uniform. 2B continuously, 2B continuously. See here, 1A, 3B. 1A, so here small. See 2A, 1B, 1A, 1B, 1A, 3B, like that, some combination will be there. And monomer within the copolymer may be organized along the backbone of the parietal base. And alternating polymer process, regularly alternating monomers A, B, a number like arrangement will be there. Second, periodic copolymer having a monomer residue type of arrangement in the repetitive sequence. And statistical copolymer have monomer residue arranged according to the known statistical rule, and the statistical copolymer is the which is the properly of finding the particular type of monomer, which is black copolymer has two or more homopolymers. If you think the polymer with two or three blacks of the two different chemicals. And dacticity. Dacticity describes the relatively stereochemistry of the choral centers in neighboring structure unit within a macro scale. There are three types, only isotetic, adaptetic, and synodiatic. It means all the substitution on the same side and random placement of the substitution. The alternating placement of the substance. This is the meaning of bacteria and how polymer morphology will be there. So polymer morphology generally describes the arrangement and microscale order of the polymer chain in the space. So now we discuss about the crystallinity. When applied to polymers, the term crystalline has a somewhat ambiguous uses in some cases. The term crystalline finds identical usage to that used in the conventional crystallography. For example, the structure of crystalline protein are polynuclei, such as a sample prepared for exoding or X-ray crystallography may be defined in the terms of conventional universal composed of one or more polymer molecules with the cell dimension of hundreds of Armstrong or more. The synthetic polymer may be lightly described as a crystalline if the crystals contain region of three-dimensional ordering on atomic length scale, usually arising from interatomic folding, stacking of adjacent chain. Synthetic polymers may consist of both crystalline and amorphous region. A degree of crystalline may be expressed in terms of weight fraction or volume fraction of the crystalline material. Few synthetic polymers also entail crystalline, and the crystallinity of the polymer is characterized by that degree of personality ranging from a zero for a completely non-personal follower to one for a theoretically completely crystalline follower. The follower with micro-crystalline regions are generally tougher and more impact resistant than totally amorphous polymer. Polymer with a degree of crystallinity approaching 0 or 1 mil tends to transparent, while polymers with intermediate degree of crystallinity will tend to obey due to the light scattering by the crystalline or glassy region. Thus, for polymer, reduced crystallinity may also associate with increasing the transparency. The chain conformation. The space occupied by the polymer molecule is generally expressed in terms of radius of saturation, which is on average distance from the center of most of the chain to the chain itself. Alternatively, it may express in terms of prevalent volume, which is volume of the solution span by polymer chain and the scale with the cube of the radius of cavitation. Mechanical property. What is mechanical property? The bulk property of the polymer is the most often of MPU's interest. Those are the property that indicate how polymer actually behaves as the microstructure. See, mechanical property is more important. It depends on your mechanical property, only your polymer product will go and sell from the outside. First one is tensile strength. Tensile strength of the material quantify how much stress of the material will endure before suffering the permanent deformation. This is the common one. And this is very important in the application that rarely happen in the polymer physical strength and durability. For example, rubber band with the higher tensile strength will hold over greater weight before snapping. In general, tensile strength is increasing with the polymer chain length and cross-linking of the polymer chain. And Young's modulus of the elasticity. Young's modulus is nothing but when you are taking your rubber band, doing like tensile stress or anything playing also, if you leave the rubber band, you should come back to the original position without any physical deformation. That is Young's modulus of the elasticity. So Young's modulus quantify the elasticity of the polymer. It's defined for small strains as the ratio of rate of change in the stress to strength, like tensile strength. This is highly relevant in the polymer application involving the physical property of the polymer, such as rubber bands. The molecule is strongly depends on the temperature. So transport properties. What is transport property? Transport property is nothing but the difficulty related to how rapidly molecules move through the polymer matrix. They are very important in the many applications of polymer for films and membranes. What is the phase behavior? When you are increasing the temperature or surrounding temperature increasing. First we will see the melting point. The term melting point, when applied the polymer, suggests not a solid liquid phase transition, but transition from the crystalline or semi-crystalline phase to solid amorphous phase. Through the appropriate, as a simple TM, means melting temperature, the property of the crystalline is more properly called as crystalline melting temperature. Among the synthetic polymer, crystalline melting is only discussed in regards of thermoplastic, as a thermoplastic polymer will decompose at the high temperature rather than melt. So it never melt, it will decompose. A glass transition temperature. A parameter of the particular interest in synthetic polymers manufactured is the glass transition temperature, which describes the temperature at which amorphous polymer undergoes a transition from the rubbery viscous amorphous solid to a brittle glassy amorphous solid. The glass transition temperature may be engineered by altering the degree of branching or cross-linking in the polymer or by the addition of dielectric polyesters. So mixing problem. Behavior. What is mixing behavior? In general, polymer mixing. are far less vessel than the vessel of small molecule material. This effect results from the fact that the driving force for mixing is usually entropy, not indirect energy. On the other hand, massive material usually form a solution not because the interaction with the other more valuable than their self-interaction, but the amount of volume available to each component. This increases the entropy scale. Furthermore, the phase between a polymer solution and mixture is more complex than the small molecule. Okay, when you are taking the phase separation occur with cooling and polymer is commonly exhibit the lower crystallization temperature phase transition at phase separation occur when the heating. And inclusion processes. Inclusion process tend to the lower TG and increase the polymer flexibility. This is another interesting thought. And polymer plasticizers are generally small molecules that are chemically similar to the polymer and create the gap between polymers, same for the greater mobility and reduce the interchange interaction. A good example of the action plasticizers related to the polymer chlorides are PVC, are UPVC, are unpolymerized polyvinyl chloride is used to things such as pipes. A pipe has no polyesters in it because its need remains strong and heat treatment. And plasticized PVC used for clothing for flexible quality. And chemical property already I told you, nitrogen, hydrogen bond, carbon, hydrogen bond, hydrogen, carbon bond, carbon and oxygen bond. If you come to our regular class, we can discuss more about the chemical property. And Sanders is polymer name question. There are multiple conversations for the naming the polymer substance. Many commonly used polymers such as those found in consumer product are referred by the common or tribal name. The tribal name is assigned based on the historical precedent or popular user rather than the standardized naming convention. Both American Chemical Society (ACS) and IUPAC proposed standardized naming conversation, and American Chemical Society and UPAC conventions are similar but not identical. So, example of different the various name conversations are given by table. So, polymer degradation. So, what is polymer degradation? The plastic item is 30 years exposed to the heat and cold, break fluid and sunlight. Notice that decolorization, swelling, damage, and time is bit running through the material. Polymer degradation is a change in the polymer and tensile strength, cooler, sharp, although such changes are frequently undesirable in such cases. So, high temperature materials such as biopolymerized, condensation polymerized, ties and place therefore are case of polymer in the form of calorimetric corrosion when the bare carbon fiber reinforced CFRB is under contact with the active metal such as aluminum in the salt water. Product failure. This is if you see this, our Amlankar, whose Amlankar has, that is my famous polymer. Tribologist in the lab. So he used to check all this work and currently he is in IIT Bangalore. He was in US in 2002. So he always used this product failure. and polymer material. There are three general groups of polymer materials: elastomers, thermoplastic, thermosets. What is elastomer? Elastomer of polymer caused high elasticity, may be reversible, stretch at high temperature, high degree. Elastomer consists of long, lightly cast linked molecules. And common elastomers are polyspoil, butyl, nitrile, ethylene propylene, acrylic silicone. And thermoplastics are polymer which soften, become a playable and plastic and melt when heated. In the melted condition, thermoplastic may be formed by various methods: emission, molding, extraction, thermoforming. No screws are linked formed. When a thermoplastic cools and hardens, thermoplastic may be a procedure. Common thermoplastics are such as LDPE and HDPE, like low density polyethylene, high density polyethylene, PVC, ABS, PMMAs, many things. And thermoset polymers which do not melt when heat. Thermoset molecules are cross-linked by strong covalent intermolecular bond, forming one pair molecule. The cross-link is achieved in curing process initiated by heat chemical agents or radiation. Before curing the process, thermoset materials are stored in particular polymerized condition. Thermosets are stronger and stiffer than the thermoplastic. Before, there are common thermosetting the polyoxide, polyethylene, unsaturated polyesters, urea formaldehyde, and aldehyde. Polymer structure. So what is polymer structure? Already we discussed, like natural or monomer or semi-crystalline. Our degree of polymer is nothing but the average number of monomers in a polymer molecule, and polymer molecules may combine up a million monomers forming a one-dimensional structure, two-dimensional structure, or three-dimensional structure. One-dimensional structure is commonly for the organic polymer. So organic polymer is one-dimensional, containing oxygen, nitrogen, chlorine, fluorine, silicon, phosphorus, or sulfur come under the organic polymer. And trans polymers consist of a molecule having side chain attached to the main. Copolymer, already told, the copolymer is a polymer molecule which is contained more than one kind of monomers. Nylon is the common copolymer. Craft polymer is a kind of branch polymer, and side chain of the which made of the monomer different from the monomer of the main chain. And block copolymer is the polymer molecule which is built alternatively polymerized blocks of two or more different polymers. Structure parameter affecting polymer properties: increasing of the chain strength, effect is increasing with temperature strength, and modulus elasticity. So property and application of the some elastomer. Elastomer polymers, these are the polymers we are using in our day-to-day life. And ceramic are the non-metallic and inorganic component formed from the metallic aluminum oxide, magnesium oxide, sodium chloride, titanium nitride, tungsten, carbide. These are the type of ceramics or semi-metallic, silicon, boron, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, amount. Some of the elements formed together in the ceramic structure by one of the following bonding mechanisms. One is maybe ionic bonding or covalent. Ionic and covalent. Most ceramic material have mixture of bonding structure with various ratios between the ionic and covalent bond. This ratio is dependent upon the difference in the electron which are the bonds between the ionic and covalent bond. And the other type of ceramic is electric negativity ionic bond, covalent bonding, ionic covalent bond. So these are the things. So I would like to stop here.